so they want to ask a question. And Lee, you want to go first?
Sure.
Okay.
What is a challenge you face as a woman of color in comedy, and how do you deal with it?
That's a great question. I love you already. I love your style. Your
everyone here is like an icon. I love it.
I started out doing stand-up 10 years ago, and that's a predominantly like white male sort of industry. And you know, I think there's just a lot of times you're like not taken seriously. There's a lot of times I would show up to shows and people would think I was like the girlfriend of a comic. You know, there's a lot of that sort of thing where you're like, oh, you do comedy? Oh, you're funny? And so it's just a lot of, you have to like prove yourself a lot. But I feel like that made me like really strong and made me like develop my voice, because I'm like, I have to believe in myself first, mm-hmm. because no one else is going to. So I think that's the hardest part, but you get that self-confidence in a way that you might not have gotten if you hadn't like look yourself in the mirror every time you go out the house and be like, I am worthy, I can do this no matter what anyone else thinks.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yes.
When I started out doing like improv sketch in high school, I found that I was surrounded by like a lot of funny guys on my team. And I wish if I had to give myself advice then, from now, I always looked around and questioned what my voice was, because I looked around and I didn't hear anybody that sounded like me. And so I think for a while early on, I wanted to emulate them. But what I found, especially with the Daily Show, especially with Two Like Queens, where we really just kind of get to be ourselves, that there's only one you, and people respond to authenticity, and truth is funny, and truth resonates, even if you're writing or anything, across any platform. So I think it's, my advice would be, you know, always stay true to you, and if you don't see people that look like you while you're going up, so what? Just keep going and just stay true to yourself. Good advice there. Ben, our time is running out. Ben, you have a question too?
Yeah, Justin, how you kind of are three steps ahead. I was going to ask, what is some advice that you would tell your younger self? Maybe Phoebe would answer that question.
Maybe Phoebe.
Sure, I'm 33. Ow. So I think what I would tell myself is don't worry as much. I think there, especially in comedy, it's like the industry a lot of times like to make you feel like if you're not the hottest thing, you're nothing. You know, and if you don't get this audition, you're garbage. And so I think there's a lot of like, you just have to realize that's false hysteria. That's fake stuff to distract you from like your purpose. And I feel like with Two Dope Queens, we figured out our purpose was to have fun, to have a great platform for other stand-up comedians. And it just like, there's no other show like us, so we're going to create that show. So just create like what you want to do. So that's what I'm telling you. So.
All right, Phoebe, Jessica, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you